Myron was more than just a broadcaster and a writer. He brilliantly used those outlets to rally Steeler Nation, but he also rallied a community to generate millions of dollars for charities from the proceeds of the terrible towel that he invented. That is so much of his legacy, but really it's only a small part of the life those dearest to him truly loved.
While Pittsburghers proudly whip terrible towels in unison downtown as a final salute to Steelers broadcasting legend Myron Cope, a few miles away, just the opposite of what we'd expect, a quiet, private service for a man who lived in the limelight.
I think that's probably the way he would have wanted. He wouldn't have liked a lot of fuss, so he probably was happy that the fuss was somewhere else and he could go away in private here.
So beautifully done, and there's a lot of choked up people, including yours truly.
You can't help but note the conditions for Myron Cope's funeral. The whipping winds, the blinding snow, weather Myron energetically sat through for three decades on Steelers Sundays alongside his close friend and colleague Bill Hillgrove, colorfully calling those games of the players who eventually became his friends.
Even though it's a sad day, we'll never forget him.
Biggest thing I think you have to say about him is he brought Steeler fans closer to Steeler football, and but beyond that, he was a great friend, and we'll miss him.
Cope left his impact on the Steelers and on WTAE, where he worked for years.
I guess the one thing I may be most proud of is putting Myron on television. I was the first person to do that, and I was told I was crazy.
In the end,
he was Pittsburgh, not just a broadcaster.
A friend to Mel Blunt and to Franco Harris, who helped carry Myron to his final resting place.
Bud, we all feel so damn lonely without him.
There was a lot of tears today at that private service. Former Steeler Rocky Blyer told us after the service that some people had been in a funeral earlier today and there was a terrible towel in the casket. He said it made him smile, one of the many silent salutes to Myron that will continue long after his death. Janelle Hall, Channel 4 Action News.